اقرأ من قوله تعالى: وإذا ما أنزلت سورة نظر بعضهم إلى بعض.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. وإذا ما أنزلت سورة نظر بعضهم إلى بعض هل يراكم من أحد ثم انصرفوا صرف الله قلوبهم بأنهم قوم لا يفقهون. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو عليه توكلت وهو رب العرش العظيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب المبين. تلك آيات الكتاب المبين. ألف لام را تلك آيات الكتاب الحكيم. أكان للناس عجبا أن أوحينا إلى رجل منهم أن أنذر الناس وبشر الذين آمنوا أن لهم قدم صدق عند ربهم. قال الكافرون إن هذا لساحر مبين.
حسبك. اقرأ من قوله تعالى: قالوا يا نوح قد جادلتنا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. قالوا يا نوح قد جادلتنا فأكثرت جدالنا فأتنا بما تعدنا إن كنت من الصادقين. قال إنما يأتيكم به الله إن شاء وما أنتم بمعجزين. ولا ينفعكم نصحي إن أردت أن أنصح لكم إن كان الله يريد أن يغويكم هو ربكم وإليه ترجعون. أم يقولون افتراه بل قل فأتوا بسورة أم يقولون افتراه بل إن افتريته فعلي أم يقولون افتراه قل فأتوا بسورة
قل إن افتريته
فعلي إجرامي وأنا بريء مما تجرمون. وأوحي إلى نوح أنه لن يؤمن من قومك إلا من قد آمن إلا من قد آمن فلا تبتئس بما كانوا يفعلون.
حسبك.
ما شاء الله جزاكم الله خيرا to Hamza Imran Mangera, and that concludes category B of the competition. We will begin category C very shortly, inshallah. Category C includes the whole of Quran, so contestants will be tested from any part of the Holy Quran, inshallah. Now, before we go to that, I would like to invite two very special guests upon to the podium. First of all, we have distinguished an honorable guest from the Malaysian High Commission, who have very kindly invited us to the Malaysian International Quran Competition that's going to take place in 2020. So the winner of the competition here tonight, one of the winners will be going over to Malaysia to represent the United Kingdom. We are honored and pleased to say that Brother Ilyas Sadiq, who is from the High Commission, is here with us today, and I would like to invite him upon to the podium to say a few words to you all, and then we will resume to another guest. So, Brother Ilyas, if I can ask you to kindly come to the stage and address our guests.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي ان الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا من سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له واشهد ان محمدا عبده ورسوله amma ba. My dear respected ulama, elders and brothers, actually I'm very humble and very honored to be here today in this gathering. Now we together with this ulama, which is, you know, the waris of the Anbiya. And today, the majlis today, the program today is, this is better than other majlis, better than other gathering. This is the gathering of Zikrullah. Other than that, today, we are gathered today to listen to the recitation of the word of Allah, Ayatullah, the Quran. So there is nothing bigger than this. So Alhamdulillah, I'm very honored. I'm very humbled to be here. And actually, I'd like to thank the Huffadh, the National Huffadh Association, who have assisted us since last year to find the right candidates to represent the UK to the event in Malaysia that we do every year. We have been doing the event of the recitation of the Quran for 61 years. The next year will be our 62nd year to do that. So I'm pleased. We are very pleased that the National Huffadh Association, especially the Brother Qari Ishaq Jasad, who has been regularly in contact with us. And I would like to extend our thank from the High Commission to the Association. And again this year, hopefully we can find the right candidate to represent the UK, inshallah.
Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much, Brother Ilyas Sadiq from the Malaysian High Commission. And we are always very grateful for the opportunity that you have given us and our youngsters to go and perform in front of a grand audience and to give our future talent a platform to perform at an international level and to develop the skills, that the amazing skill that they have already acquired. Next up, I would like to invite Brother Mas'ud Ahmed, who is the Assistant Secretary General of Muslim Council of Britain. Muslim Council of Britain is the leading Muslim body that represents mosques and Islamic institutions all around the UK, and they are often called upon to support causes that affect the Muslims. And we are very humbled and grateful to the MCB for extending their support to the UK Huffadh Association and supporting the competition. I'd like to invite upon the podium Brother Masood Ahmed to address you all, inshallah.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Dear brothers and sisters, respected ulama, teachers of the Huffadh, mothers, fathers, and all the honorable guests, including the High Commissioner of the Malaysian Embassy, Brother Ali As-Sadiq. It's a great honor to stand here to say a few words to those I consider the cream of the cream of our community. As they say, creme de la creme. If you know the Quran, you are the best. There's no doubt about it. خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنَ وَعَلَّمَهُ. And especially, if you know the Quran and you can teach it, then you are definitely the best. That's what the Prophet ﷺ said. The best amongst you are those who learn the Quran and teach to others. So, those of you who have taken part in this competition, and those who will win, you all have to consider yourself that you are winners right from the start. Because by learning the Quran, you are already amongst the best. That's the first thing to know. What we also need to learn is that nowadays there is a lot being said about the Quran. Just a few days ago, I don't know if any of you watch Question Time. I was watching it. A lady amongst the audience was given the opportunity to say something that made me so upset. And I'm sure many of you, if you heard it, also felt very upset that on a national television, we were allowed to listen to so much hatred and so much ignorance about the Quran. Dear brothers and sisters, this lady, she said that the Quran teaches Muslims to go and tell lies, to lie about their religion, to lie about things. And she went on to say many other things, which you can find out if you want to go and do some research. The Quran doesn't teach any such thing. The Quran that I know, and the Quran that you know, I can assure you, it teaches us to love each other. The Quran that I know and you know, it teaches us to honor people, Muslim or non-Muslim, to love our neighbors, to care for our parents, to respect everybody. The Quran that we know teaches us to stand for justice, whether it is be for rich or poor, whether it is for those who are related to you or not. It even teaches us to stand up for justice, even against our own selves. Dear brothers and sisters, there is so much ignorance about the Quran, and I want to congratulate National Huffadh Association, and particularly the founder and CEO of this organization, Brother Ishaq Jasad, for his courage at this turbulent time to stand up for something like this, to initiate something like this, and to encourage our youth to memorize the Quran. It takes a lot to memorize the Quran. It's no ordinary business. I don't know of any other religion or any other religious book that people memorize from cover to cover to the letter without any mistake. So for that reason, each one of you deserve to be congratulated. And if you learn the lessons from the Quran, you will be even better. You will be amongst the best of the best. You will be raised on the day of judgment amongst the shuhada, amongst the anbiya, amongst the prophets and messengers of Allah. So it's no simple task. It's a very ambitious mission. But each one of you have taken a big task to be part of this. And those of you, particularly, who do not make it to the final, who do not win the final award. Don't be disheartened. Take it as a challenge. Continue your competition, and inshallah, you'll realize that you'll go from strength to strength. And parents and guardians, those of you who have brought them here, just because they didn't win the award, please don't have a go at them. Give them an extra treat. Buy them something extra. Give them something healthy or whatever pleases them, something decent, so that they feel honored because they have already taken part in something that takes a lot. You put yourself in their situation, you probably can't do it. So don't be so harsh on them. Be kind to them. And those who win, may Allah bless you and give you strength so that you can go from strength to strength. I could speak for days, for a lot longer, Brother Sultan knows, but let me stop here and congratulate everybody who's involved in this great effort. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. And on behalf of Muslim Council of Britain, it gives me great pleasure that such an effort is taking place. And I hope that this effort continues. And I hope each one of you continue to learn the lessons of the words that you are memorizing, so that by word and by action, you will be a good Muslim, a great example. What is needed nowadays, we need great leadership, not people who are dishonest, not people who are untruthful, not people who are clever, but they actually are dishonest. We need people who can stand up for the truth. And that's why we need people like yourselves coming forward, providing leadership in the community. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless every one of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Jazakallah khair. Thank you very much, Brother Mas'ud, for those inspiring words. And like he said, this work of Quran is no easy task. And this is why when kids who have memorized the Quran come up in front of me and in front of all of us and recite, we must first and foremost look at them with the eyes of aspiration, with the eyes of admiration for the work they have done. Because it's like a degree. It takes a good part of 3 years to get a degree. And it takes, on average, a reciter 3.5 years to memorize the Quran. So for kids that do it at the age of 7, 8, 10, 15, it's almost like doing a whole degree memorizing the Quran. So it's a lot of effort that the kids go through. But also, parents must be congratulated. Teachers must be congratulated for the hard work that they do. Moving on, we have a few more guests and a lot of entertainment that you will be looking forward to. I'm pleased to say our brother Omar Issa has joined us, and we have representatives. Our brother Abdul Rahman from Al Manar Mosque is also here. And we've also got distinguished guests from Malaysia, Brother Sinan and his team from Digital Durian. Have you guys heard of Omar and Hannah series on YouTube? For those of your kids, you must have come across Omar and Hannah, this new cartoon that's very Islamic and encourages all these good habits. So the developers and the CEO is also here amongst us. So we are honored. Shall we get started with Category C? Okay. In Category C, we have six contestants. I will name the contestants. If I can ask all the contestants to be sat on the second row, behind the front row, inshallah. And the contestants are as follows. Safwanuddin Ahmed, Ibrahim Ahmed, Muhammad Ahmed, Talha Dalal, Umar Jilani, and Hammam Yusuf. Right, so let's begin Category C with a recitation of Safwanuddin Ahmed, contestant number 089.
اقرأ من قوله تعالى منيبين إليه واتقوه وأقيموا الصلاة.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. منيبين إليه واتقوه وأقيموا الصلاة. منيبين إليه واتقوه وأقيموا الصلاة. منيبين إليه واتقوه وأقيموا الصلاة ولا تقول. منيبين إليه واتقوه وأقيموا الصلاة
ولا تكونوا من المشركين.
منيبين إليه واتقوه وأقيموا الصلاة ولا تكونوا من المشركين من الذين فرقوا دينهم وكانوا شيعا كل حزب بما لديهم فرحون وإذا مس الناس ضر دعوا ربهم منيبين دعوا ربهم منيبين إليه ثم إذا أذاقهم منه رحمة إذا فريق منهم بربهم يشركون ليكفروا بما آتيناهم وليتمتعوا فسوف يعلمون أولم يروا أن منيبين إليه واتقوه أقيموا الصلاة ولا تكونوا من المشركين من الذين فرقوا دينهم وكانوا شيعا كل حزب بما لديهم فرحون وإذا مس الناس ضر دعوا ربهم منيبين إليه ثم إذا أذاقهم منه رحمة إذا فريق منهم بربهم يشركون ليكفروا بما آتيناهم فتمتعوا فسوف تعلمون ويجعلون لما لا يعلم أم أنزلنا عليهم سلطانا فهو يتكلم بما كانوا به يشركون
حسبك اقرأ من قوله تعالى ومن آياته الجوار في البحر كالأعلام
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن آياته الجوار في البحر كالأعلام إن يشأ يسكن الريح فيظلم
ومن آياته الجوار في البحر كالأعلام
ومن آياته الجوار في البحر كالأعلام إن يشأ يسكن الريح فيظلل رواكد على ظهره إن في ذلك لآيات لكل صبار شكور وإذا غشيهم إن في ذلك لآيات لكل صبار شكور ولقد صدق عليهم إبليس
أو يوبقهن بما كسبوا
ويعفو عن كثير ويعلم الذين يجادلون في آياتنا ما لهم من محيص فما أوتيتم من شيء فمتاع الحياة الدنيا وزينة
فمتاع الحياة الدنيا
وما عند الله خير وأبقى للذين آمنوا وعلى ربهم يتوكلون
حسبك
فأما الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فيدخلهم ربهم في رحمته ذلك هو الفوز المبين وأما الذين كفروا أفلم تكن آياتي تتلى عليكم فاستكبرتم وكنتم قوما مجرمين وإذا قيل إن وعد الله حق هذا كتابنا ينطق عليكم بالحق إنا كنا نستنسخ ما كنتم تعملون فأما الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فيدخلهم ربهم في رحمته ذلك هو الفوز المبين وأما الذين كفروا أفلم تكن آياتي تتلى عليكم فاستكبرتم وكنتم قوما مجرمين وإذا قيل إن وعد الله حق
والساعة لا ريب فيها
وإذا قيل إن وعد الله حق والساعة لا ريب فيها قلتم ما ندري ما الساعة إن ظن إلا ظنا وما نحن بمستيقنين وبدا لهم سيئات ما عملوا وحاق بهم ما كانوا به يستهزئون.
حسبك. اقرأ من قوله تعالى: يوصيكم الله في أولادكم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. يوصيكم الله في أولادكم للذكر مثل حظ الأنثيين فإن كن نساء فوق اثنتين فلهن ثلثا ما ترك وإن كانت واحدة فلها النصف ولأبويه لكل واحد منهما السدس مما ترك إن كان له ولد فإن لم يكن له ولد وورثه أبواه فلأمه الثلث فإن كان له إخوة فلأمه السدس من بعد وصية يوصي بها أو دين. آباؤكم وأبناؤكم لا تدرون أيهم أقرب لكم نفعا فريضة من الله إن الله كان عليما حكيما.
حسبك. اقرأ من قوله تعالى: يا أيها النبي إذا جاءك المؤمنات.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا أيها النبي إذا جاءك المؤمنات يبايعنك على ألا يشركن بالله شيئا ولا يسرقن ولا يزنين ولا يقتلن أولادهن ولا يأتين ببهتان يفترينه بين أيديهن وأرجلهن ولا يعصينك في معروف فبايعهن واستغفر لهن الله إن الله غفور رحيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تتولوا قوما غضب الله عليهم قد يئسوا من الآخرة كما يئس الكفار من أصحاب القبور. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبح لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وهو العزيز الحكيم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لم تقولون ما لا تفعلون.
حسبك. اقرأ من قوله تعالى: إن تحرص على هداهم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. إن تحرص على هداهم فإن الله لا يهدي من يضل وما لهم من ناصرين وأقسموا بالله جهد أيمانهم لا يبعث الله من يموت بلى وعدا عليه حقا ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون ليبين لهم الذي يختلفون فيه وليعلم الذين كفروا أنهم كانوا كاذبين إنما قولنا لشيء إذا أردناه أن نقول له كن فيكون والذين هاجروا في الله من بعد ما ظلموا لنبوئنهم في الدنيا حسنة ولأجر الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون
حسبك.